I said I don't have any bananas. Get out of here. Hey, get. I don't have any bananas. God. So annoying. After the horrible events that transpired yesterday, the chimpanzee's family pressed charges. I was brought into the courtroom to appear in front of the council of the elder monkeys. The eldest monkey made it clear that I was guilty of all my crimes, and I was sentenced to jail for 30 days. My first day behind bars was already rough after I dropped the soap. Oh my god. When I woke up, I had half health from the shower incident, and I realized that the gorilla from the shower was my new cellmate, and I knew this was going to be a long 30 days. When I was using the bathroom, I noticed someone was at the door. Apparently, they gave me a lawyer, and they were going to try to get me out of jail by saying the incident was self-defense. My lawyer took me to a private room, and he started asking me questions about what happened that night. He gave me some water, so I decided to drink it, but then my vision went dark. When I woke back up, my lawyer had turned into a gorilla and started attacking me. I pulled out my concealed weapon and started swinging. I now had two murders on my hands, and I knew there were people inside the prison system that wanted me dead, and I don't know why. Well, I do know why. It's because I murdered a chimpanzee, but we don't know for sure. I knew the guards would be coming for me, so I had to find the quickest way to break out of jail, but I knew how. I ran all the way over to the cafeteria and found as much bananas as I could. I needed all the monkeys mad, so I went to every cell and started smacking them with bananas. Even the naked ones in the shower, this was crucial. Soon I had the whole cafeteria busting with monkeys, and I found the sewer entrance right behind the stairwell. The prison riot bought me just enough time to break through into the sewer, and I was free. Oh, that could not have gone any smoother. Oh. I was expecting another shower incident, but then I noticed something familiar. Wait a minute. Harambe? Harambe, you're alive! You're alive! We embraced for a few moments, but after, he told me that they have a secret monkey faction hiding in the sewers, and I need to come with him now. He told me to travel down the sewer until I found a secret room. Sure enough, I found the door to the secret monkey faction, and we were in. Fortunately, Harambe tells me the terrible truth. He told me that the chimpanzee that came to my house that one night was actually sent by the monkey government to kill me, but they don't know why. He says there are too many traitors in the system. There may be even traitors on the monkey council, but all they know is that they want me dead for a reason. Something important. Harambe gave me something. It was a map. He said there were ancient legends about the wisest monkey that ever lived, and he had a temple deep in the jungle. Harambe said that he is our only chance at learning what the government wants from me. Harambe said he couldn't come with me, so I had to say goodbye.
Goodbye, Harambe.
After making intense love with Harambe, I started on my journey. I traveled for days until I finally found the jungle I was looking for. The jungle of the ancient monkey. I began to think it was just a legend, but then I finally found the temple. But something was off. There were bananas everywhere in the entrance. I made my way into the temple looking for signs of the ancient monkey, but I found nothing. It was completely empty. But when I found a drop of blood on the ground, I knew something was terribly wrong. I made my way into the throne room and found only bones and blood on the throne. Someone knew I was coming and murdered the ancient monkey. I had no clue what to do or where to go until I found a broken hole in the back of the room. Something or someone was here before me, and it looks like they found what they were looking for. I had to find out what was down there. It looked like some secret artifact room. I went over and started to read the stories inscribed on the painting. It seemed to talk about some ancient war between monkeys and humans. There were other artifacts too, but they didn't seem important. But there was a whole nother room for a special painting. It seemed to talk about the ancient monkey. He had a son, but feared he would be more powerful than him, so he cast him out. This was too much information. I needed to leave. I didn't know my parents well. They were villagers, but they died when I was young. But there is something I won't forget about that explosion. There was something in the wreckage. Something that shouldn't have been there. I woke up from the explosion not knowing where I was, but I knew I had to leave right away. This is now the second time that someone's tried killing me. I journeyed through the jungle until I found a small cave. There was a monkey with a campfire, and he told me I could stay the night if I did one thing. After seeing those shiny cheeks, I knew I had to give him a spank, and he let me stay the night. When I woke up, there was a parrot in the cave. The parrot had dropped off what looked like to be a book for me. It was a message from the monkey faction. The government found all of them in the sewers right after I left. They tortured Harambe until he gave up my location, and now they're all imprisoned. It looks like I have to save Harambe. If I was gonna save Harambe, I needed to get stacked. It was time to save Harambe. I made my way all the way back to the prison I came from. But just as I was coming over the hill to scout it out, the Elder Monkey appeared right behind me, the one that sent me to jail. He told me that Harambe wasn't at that prison. He's being held at the maximum security Monkey Kingdom. He says there may be other traitors on the council with him. The question now is, can I trust the Elder Monkey? The entrance to the Monkey Kingdom was being guarded by two gorillas. The plan was simple: invisibility potion, get in, get out, no witnesses. I didn't know if I could trust the Elder Monkey, but I had no choice. Harambe needed to be saved. I got past the guard gorillas and made it into the entrance. I needed to wait for a monkey to come and open the doors for me so I could slip through unnoticed. But soon enough, a chimpanzee came through and I was in. The Elder Monkey told me the prison was on the left door, so I made my way down. To my surprise, there were no more guards down here, so I checked every cell for Harambe. I was beginning to doubt the Elder Monkey until the very last cell. Harambe was here. Harambe, let's go, we gotta get you out of here. He wasn't responding, so I broke open the cell. Harambe, let's go, we gotta get out of here. Harambe? A decoy. I heard the door shut behind me. It was the Elder Monkey. I opened my eyes and I was trapped in the middle of what looked like to be the throne room of the Elder Monkey. The Elder Monkey spoke. He said it took him long enough to get me here. I asked him what he wanted from me. He said I proved my worth after he tried having me killed in the prison and in the temple. He knew that I could serve a better purpose. So I take it you're the head of the corrupt government. He said the government was just a name, and there are powers that I cannot comprehend, but all will be revealed soon. He said he needed me to retrieve a ritual for him, somewhere in another dimension. I asked him why I would ever help him, and then he showed me. It was Harambe. The Elder Monkey was holding him as prisoner. The Elder Monkey said, if I don't bring him the ritual, Harambe will be dead. The Elder Monkey told me I would find the portal to this dimension somewhere in the cold. Goodbye, Harambe. I will save you. I traveled until I finally found the snow biome, and I saw a village up ahead. I had no information at all, so maybe the villagers knew something. I asked them what they knew, and they said there was a rumor about a portal deep in the ice spikes, but no one has ever come back. I knew this was my only chance to save Harambe, so I had to try. I had too many questions. Why did the Elder Monkey want me dead? What are his real plans? What is this ritual, and what does he want it for? I wish I had more time to think, but then I came up on the portal. I knew whatever was in there was gonna be dangerous, but Harambe needed my help. And if there was any chance I was gonna save him, this was my one chance. I made it through the portal. I understand now why the Elder Monkey sent me. This place was dangerous, but he knew I could survive. After looking around a bit, I knew I had to go across the lava, over to that tree. I started making the jumps across the lava. If I fell once, it was over. Looking at all the skulls here, it seemed like the Elder Monkey has sent more people before me. But I finally made it across, until I came across a tree that looked very old. I took a step inside, and there was a book waiting for me. I jumped and grabbed it and opened it. It was the ritual. It was called the Lost Weapon. The ritual spoke about how to summon this weapon. The book says that the weapon's powers are limitless. This part confused me. It said the weapon could only be summoned by the ancient monkey. But that didn't make any sense. The ancient monkey was dead. Unless he never was. I made my way back through the portal. This made no sense. The ancient monkey has to be alive to summon the weapon. I didn't have time to think. I had to get back to the prison and save Harambe. The scariest part was that I had no plan. No escape, no idea what the Elder Monkey wants to do with the ritual, and worst of all, no trust in the Elder Monkey. But I had no choice. Harambe had to be saved. I made my way up the stairs. The Elder Monkey said he knew I would make it back. He told me to hand over the ritual. I gave you what you want, now let Harambe go. The Elder Monkey called me a fool for trusting him. He also called Harambe a fool for trusting me. I turned around and there were gorilla guards waiting for me. Harambe and I were being sentenced to death. We had 1 minute until the trap doors opened and we were gone. Harambe, I just thought I was meant for more. There's so much that doesn't make any sense, and I just want to know why it had to be me. I just wish we had more time. It felt like we just met each other. Just when we were about to die, we almost died by another explosion. Outside of the jungle, there were two villagers waiting for us. They said I needed to go with them right now. Harambe said he had something to do, and he couldn't come with me. I trusted him, and said goodbye. The villagers said nothing, until I finally realized where we were going. My home. I haven't been back to the village ever since my parents were blown up. The villager told me everything would be alright, so I made my way into the village. The two villagers who broke me out told me the village leader wanted to see me. I found him, and he told me to come inside. I started to tell him my whole story. The elder monkey, the ancient monkey, the ritual, everything I knew. The village leader said he knew all this. He told me that the ancient war between monkeys and humans was never won. People just forgot about it. He said I don't have much time, but there is something that the village hid. Something from my parents' explosion. He told me to head over to the house where my parents died. I didn't see anything, but I noticed the fake stair. There was a secret ladder underneath. I knew what was coming, but I didn't have the strength to accept it. Bananas. From the day my parents died. There were monkeys. I was in such disbelief, and I almost didn't notice what was in the middle. It was my father's bow. This was my last memory of my father, and I had to cherish it. All of a sudden, I was poisoned. I had to get out of here. Someone knew I would come looking for this, and they trapped it. My consciousness was slipping. I had to get help. I barely made it to the door of the house, but right before... I woke up. I must have passed out. The village leader was here with me, and he said I was fine. But he said I needed to move now. He told me the ancient monkey would be at the monkey temple trying to summon the weapon. And if he does, he'll use it to destroy the human capital. The village was kind enough to let me use their horse. I needed to get to the monkey temple as fast as possible. My people had trust in me. I rode for a long time until I finally found the jungle, but the jungle got too dense, and I had to let my horse go. It was raining hard, but I managed to find the temple. But I was too late. There were guards at the entrance. I had to hide. I got up on the tree to see what was going on. I saw the ritual, but I saw no ancient monkey. All of a sudden, lightning just struck the temple, and in the wreckage, it was the elder monkey, and he now had the weapon. I had to warn the capital. I went as fast as I could until I found the mountains. I had to warn them about the incoming attack. I couldn't believe the ancient monkey was the elder monkey the whole time, but I didn't have time to think about it. I went up to two villagers and started telling them about the attack coming, but they just stood there, and they didn't even believe me. I had to find the capital leader. I had to warn him. Two villagers told me he lives in the windmill. I made my way over, and I found the capital leader. I started immediately telling him about the ancient monkey's plan. I told him that he wants to wipe out all humans by taking the capital first. But the capital leader just stood there. He said humans and monkeys have been at peace for years. I knew I didn't have time to convince him. I had to get ready to defend the capital. I looked for anything I could until I finally found a chest full of arrows. I knew what I was gonna do. I had to send a message to the whole capital. I climbed up to the watchtower. As the sun rose, I looked over to the battle torch that hasn't been lit in years. This was my only chance. I took my father's bow and shot an arrow. And I lit up the battle torch. But right as that happened, it started to pour. I knew what was coming. I looked towards the mountains, and I saw him. I climbed down to fight, but right as I got to the bottom, there was a gorilla waiting for me. I woke up in a cell. I had no clue what had happened, until I looked around. The capital streets in flames. Villagers burning. We lost the capital. I turned, and the ancient monkey was floating right in front of me, with a child. The ancient monkey said there was no point in resisting. The war is over, and all humans will become monkeys. The ancient monkey turned the kid into a chimpanzee right in front of my eyes, and there was nothing I could do to stop him. But that's when I saw hope. It was Harambe. He came back. All of a sudden, I turned around, and there was a bomb ready to explode. I was free. I had to make my way over to Harambe. I shot any chimpanzee in my way, and I ran over as fast as I could.
Harambe, you came back.
Harambe told me to go into the mine, and what I saw was all of the monkeys from the prison. Harambe, this is our only shot, and we have to make it work. Do you trust me? That was a yes. One by one, I started taking out every chimpanzee that was in my way. I had all of the monkeys from jail working with me, so I wasn't alone. But then I saw the ancient monkey. I took a shot, but he stopped at midair. All of a sudden, he struck me with lightning. I had to figure out how to get a different angle on him. I went over to the mountains and took a shot, but he sensed it coming. As long as he had the lost weapon, My bow did nothing to him. I had to bring the fight to him. I swam on over, not knowing what I was gonna do. But when I looked up on the roof, Harambe was behind him and he was sneaking up. Harambe blew the ancient monkey off of the building. The lost weapon was on the ground. I knew I had to do this. I ran and dove for it. I knew there was only one way this ended, and I had to go for it. I brought the ancient monkey and I as high as possible. The ancient monkey said, "I've just killed us both." "I know, but everyone will live." The ancient monkey said that the legends were true, and his son was truly more powerful than he was. And that's when I knew. I was the ancient monkey's son, and this was my destiny, to defeat my father. "It's over, Dad." I said one final goodbye to Harambe, and then I let go. This was the ending I wanted. I found my purpose. I brought the humans and monkeys together. And I saved the world. I thought I was ready to see my parents, but they weren't ready for me. Harambe was gonna need my help. And when he did, I would be there.